Hello everyone. So welcome to another Ascension related update. Yes, you might get frequently updates now from now onwards because there are a lot of changes that are taking place. And it's my prime responsibility to keep you all updated on the same because there is a lot that is being done now and a lot of equations are changing on your personal level. You would remember that I categorically mentioned in my earlier videos that there'll be a lot of changes, not videos, the audios I mean. There are a lot of changes. There's a refurbishment or renovation of Mother Earth going on. Now, when it comes to your personal life, let me remind you, there's a lot of equation change that is about to take place. Okay? So be prepared. In that point, you have to be very clear. Your workplace, your personal equation with someone, your relationship status, everything is going to go for a big roller coaster ride now. I'll tell you why, because there is a lot of giving away of things that are unwanted in our life. All right. So it is like this. If certain relationships are not good for you and you are still clinging on just for the heck of it and kind of duty bound or just like that, now they will be just taken with a force. They'll be pulled away from you. So either you decide amicably to move out, else the parting away will be very difficult for you because emotionally you will not be prepared and then it'll be the dynamics will be very different. Okay, what you are supposed to understand here is the underlying factor of any step you take from here onwards has to be a lot of love, compassion within you. Okay, any step you take, be it if you are undergoing a divorce, if you are planning to stop or cut off any relationship for that matter, first things first, you will have to understand you cannot afford to do a blame game and then cut off. Okay, let's be very frank on that, because now you will have to be very mindful as to what you're thinking and what you're doing. Okay, you'll have to be very particular about your personal feel at this point of time. Let me remind you guys, that's a beautiful, powerful manifestation time. Whatever you are going to think, you are going to do, that will get manifested. And as I always say, what you think or what you feel for others will come back 10 times to you. So now understand, if I say it's a powerful manifestation period, so it goes as simple as that. If I think or talk nasty or ill about someone, it'll come back 10 times. Okay? If I really try to show down someone, I blame someone or I pull down someone or I hurt someone publicly, it'll come back as public humiliation to us. So, you'll have to be very careful about this time period right now, because the entire dynamics are going to change now. Either you decide to ascend or you decide to stay back and really have a tough time now cleansing yourself. So there has been enough of time given to all of us as human beings to understand and balance the relationships, whatever we had. If we really didn't feel good, we should have walked out. If we are still continuing, there has to be a specific and very strong reason for us, because we understand at the soul level there is something still left in this relationship, isn't it? So just honor that feeling. Give more weightage to the feeling of love and compassion. If you are undergoing some real bad patch in a relationship or in your professional front, keep yourself in the other person's shoe and then judge the situation. Okay, I repeat, if you are at the receiving end, if you have received a blow, if you have been misjudged, just for a moment, just stay calm. Keep yourself in the other person's shoe and analyze the entire situation. There has to be certain specific reason for that person to behave in a certain manner. This is what you are supposed to consciously do now. I'm going to help you understand how to really find some help right now. See, there's a small exercise I would want all of you to do now. It is critical. Let me tell you, all of you, it is very critical for all of you who have a lot of challenges in your personal relationships or in life in particular. You are really unable to sort out certain aspects of your life. I'm going to help you understand how to sort that out. Now, take a paper and pen. There are certain questions you will have to answer those questions for your own personal benefit. All right. So if you want, you can pause the audio right now. Go grab a pen and a kind of notebook or paper, and then jot down the questions I'm going to ask you, because you have to answer these questions in a very honest manner. You have to be very true to yourself now. This is the time, guys, to be very true and honest to your own self. Forget about any frills, any tag-ons, any kid or husband or wife or mother or father or anyone for that matter. Just be very, very, very honest with yourself. It is your individual journey as of now, and you have to answer certain harsh questions very honestly. First thing, if you are facing a very challenging relationship or equation with a particular person, then I would want you to ask yourself that, how balanced are you feeling? Are you really enjoying that relationship? Are you really feeling balanced, or do you feel with that relationship by your side from years together, if you look, you have really grown as a human being? Okay, ask yourself and answer that question. Sorry about that. Lately, I have realized whenever I record an audio, there has to be someone at the door. Very strange, no? Anyways, coming back to the audio. So, where was I? Yes. So, you need to really ask yourself, do you really feel balanced? Do you really enjoy? Okay? Be very honest. Another thing, what you need to ask yourself, the next question will be, are you really able to live your life the way you want? Are you really yourself? Are you feeling free? Are you getting that freedom to live the way you want it? Okay, that's the second thing you need to answer. If not, for because of whom? Okay, you need to answer that also. If you are unable to answer that question, then ask yourself, because of whom I am unable to feel free? Now, you are also supposed to really answer this question. What kind of relationship are you looking for, basically? See, because human beings are complicated. Everyone has certain flaws. Okay? If not this particular person with whom you are having challenging situation, or ask yourself, what would make me happy? What kind of status quo will make me happy? The relationship equation. And then, please be very true and honest and ask yourself, the expectation you have, does it really coincide with the kind of person you are? Will you be able to manage your life with that kind of a person? Because for you to have that sort of a person in relationship, there are certain dynamics that you need to change within you. So you have to ask yourself, am I really correct to accept and expect such a kind of relationship that I have been hoping for? Or it is like there has been some repetitive pattern of my own behavior and own mindset, because of which I undergo a particular pain in my life. Okay? See, I'll tell you, it is very simple. We take birth to experience certain things on this planet Earth, right? Now, for us to ensure that our journey is taken care of in the initial days, we choose our parents. You know, we need a medium to come to this world. So we choose our parents. There are certain souls we choose as parents and so on and so forth. Now, after that, once we start growing up, we start looking here and there and we start comparing our life with others. That is where our all the dynamics change from there. It is from there the downfall starts, because now I am hovering between my life and others' life. I am constantly questioning, why am I not so happy the way my friend is happy? Why couldn't I get that kind of a family the way the kind of family my friend has been gifted with? You know, so these numerous questions keep coming because we tend to forget our individual journey is different. And unknowingly, in our subconscious mind, we fill all filth. So today, when you look back, ask yourself, is your current relationship a result of all that you have accumulated in your subconscious mind just by looking at the adults who were around you and the way they behaved in a particular relationship? Is it what taught you to be the same? You'll be surprised that yes, there are a lot of things that have affected you. You'll get a lot of clarity after this exercise. Answer very honestly. See, remember, why I'm asking you to do this exercise is because you are reflecting your own self right now amongst people whom you encounter every day. Okay? How do I explain you? Now, if you are facing some sort of negligence or some sort of isolation from people, it is because probably somewhere you demanded that. You sent that message to universe that yes, I need isolation. Okay? I want that gap. All right? If I have been talking or ill about others, then I have sent enough proof to the universe that yes, I don't mind talking ill about others. So yes, bring it on. So today, when 10 people talk ill about myself, I should not feel shattered, because this is the energy I created initially and I sent it to the universe. So at this point of time, you will have to understand whatever you have cultivated, you know, that is what is exactly reflecting back. You wanted something, you have been given that. Be grateful. Always remember that there is some divine force that is always guiding and supporting and is always full of love and compassion. Come to think of it, in your relationship dynamics, if someone is not in the right spirit and you try to backbite or you try to show that person that you are good for nothing, how would you feel if the divine force decides to do the same thing with you? There are so many of us and we would have committed so many mistakes, right? We would have done so many things which were not correct in the eyes of the divine power, which we aren't aware of. We feel that this is right and this is wrong depending on the society norms and conditions, because the society has taught us a specific way of living is correct, a specific way of behaving is correct, and exactly that is what we have been following all these years, for years together. But you know what? There is nothing right, nothing wrong. Everything is an experience. And people, we learn from our experience. We have come here basically to learn and grow at the soul level. Some people learn it the hard way. And you know why they learn it the hard way? Because of their own stubbornity. They have a lot of rigid attitude and behavior that they feel that they are right in what they think, because of their judgmental behavior, because they tend to judge others. every time in a specific way. So each time I keep judging a person in a negative manner, I'm sowing seeds of something negative. And that is surely against that particular relation. So, you know, when you are yourself sowing the seed, don't get scared when it just sprouts and becomes a huge tree one fine day. And you are full of negativity now. So remember the relationship dynamics. They have to be now very clear on your mind. And please stop people pleasing anymore. I repeat, do not fall prey to people who have got a habit of talking very sweetly in front of you and who bitch around while you are not there. So all those people who do this, let me warn you, you are being properly seen and you will have to face the music very soon. This is not going to work now, all right? You were very well aware you have come here to live life out of love and compassion and not of, you know, showing people that you are good in front and then talking ill about those people when they are not there. These are all very wrong dynamics. So, you know, our society has taught us that be very good to others, you know, talk sweetly to others. You really think that if you have venom against someone and you are talking sweetly, you are being pardoned? No. Be clear at heart. That is the first lesson you need to learn now. While ascension is on, you have to understand, you have to be very clean in your heart. You are no one to judge any person's life, any person's problems. You have no idea why that person is undergoing a certain problem. So the dynamics are very different. We have been always taught, you know, like we have to please everyone. We have to take care of our elders. We have to listen to them, whatever they are saying. We should understand that. We have to be then very conscious of not hurting them. See, these are very old dynamics. Today, you have to understand you have your own six senses which have been gifted to you. Okay? You are your own master. You are the creator of your life. Do not let any wrong teachings or preachings of the society or your elders in your lineage really deter your progress. Okay? Learn from their mistakes. Learn what they did and how they fell prey to certain things which were not right. Do not commit the same mistake. Okay? Another thing, right now many people will need your help. Okay, so try to help each other. Do not try to backstab or step over someone for your own goodness. There are a lot of people who will be breaking down now emotionally because they could not cleanse themselves. When the time was given, they could not cleanse themselves and they took a lot of time just because of their rigidity and their own materialistic happiness. They didn't realize what the higher self was trying to say. So now they are going to have real tough time. So be prepared. There'll be a lot of people around you who will be really falling apart because it is like starting afresh. There will be a lot of things you will have to start afresh. It will be a new beginning, a new life altogether. So they will have to be guided properly. Okay? So you will have to take care of yourself. You have to take care of your family and friends who are really falling around now big time, who could not work on themselves. Help them with the tools. Help them open up spiritually more. That is the biggest help you can do now. Show them the path. Show them the light. Tell them there is no other way out. They can come out of their trauma. Give them the gift of knowing themselves better, you know. They have to know their inner self. They have to manage their emotions now. They can't keep blaming, threatening. They can't feel jealous. They can't think that only others are wrong. They have to own their problems. They have to own their mistakes. They have to understand, I have created, now I can only change the creation, right? See, when you take a paper, a pencil, you are drawing something. If you didn't find it good enough, you will only have to decide, no, whether you want to erase it or not. The paper will not do it for you. The pencil can only draw, but it's your hand that has to lift up, lift the pencil and then create. And it's through your thought process you're going to create, through your imagination. Your six senses are going to work there, your feel, your touch, your eyes, the way you see, the way you judge. So yes, if there are failures in your life or anyone who is connected with you, they are facing some sort of failure, help them see the reality. Tell them they are reflecting their own things that they did wrong. Help them understand that it is useless to hold on to something that is not meant for them. It will be snatched away from them now, because now they are not serving any purpose in their life. So be it their relationship with anyone, be it any place, if you are at a place, you are totally in love with that place and suddenly overnight you have to shift, be prepared. All these things are going to happen now. Do your inner healing work as much as possible now. Nothing can help you right now but for your own inner work. Stop helping others without helping your own self. First, cleanse your own body, your soul, your mind. It is high time now. That smell, that rotten smell which you keep getting and thinking that it is from your neighbor's house, no. Check your own dustbin. Check the filth that is around your own house. Might be the corners are not clean. So please help cleanse your system first. Your vessel needs to be clean now, because there are a lot of changes coming in. If you don't do it willingly, you don't take out time to do so, you will be taken for a very powerful joyride, and then you will have to just scream and shout and yell and cry. So the choice is yours. Either do it immediately with immediate effect. Cleanse yourself. Love yourself. Do something to make yourself happy so that you emit that vibration around, so that whosoever comes to you is always finding peace and happiness and love and joy around you. Another thing, don't overdo anything, guys, right now. Do not overdo spirituality. Do not overdo serious stuff. If you are into meditation, you are doing hours and hours of meditation, please don't do. These are not going to work now. Strike a balance. As I said, February is the month of balancing. Please balance your life in a proper way. Balance your spiritual life and your personal life and your professional life. Balance. There has to be a balance in your body, mind and soul. There has to be a connection between your heart and mind. All those people who are spiritually awakened and in their family, others are not. Don't try to, you know, think that they are very low and they don't understand. Now it's time for you to, some way or the other, try to talk good things to them so that, you know, they get attracted to this life also, wherein they decide that, yes, I want to know more about life. I want to learn. Don't let your ego surface up. Try to help them. Okay? And yes, be prepared. There will be a major change. So many of you might be feeling that you have come to the bottom, you know, rock bottom, wherein like you feel that you are finished now. But when you hit the bottom, only then you can rise really high. Okay, so remember that. If you are facing that, don't lose hope. There are a lot of good things that can come and will come, provided you decide to cleanse your system properly. So remember, guys, no grudges against anyone, no complaints against anyone. It is your life, you chose. If you are unhappy, you are responsible. If you are angry, you are responsible. If you are happy, you are responsible. So let you take charge of your emotions and start working on those and be very clear. Everything has happened for a reason. Ask yourself, are you trying to control others a lot? Are you trying to control others' thought process a lot? Are you trying to teach others a lot how to treat you? Ask yourself. You will really understand that the compassion was missing in the relationship, and it was more of, you know, you were trying to mold someone as per your suitability. Don't do that. Whenever there is a variety, it adds, it spices up, you know, it really feels good. No one likes a monotonous life, you know. There is always a room for something different. So we have been made a particular way for a specific reason. We need to learn from each other. We need to grow by understanding each other and not by stepping down or not by showing them that they are good for nothing and we are very attained souls. No. Everyone has their own flaws and everyone has their own strengths. Just respect each other, love each other, and then grow. There's a beautiful life ahead, but you need to cleanse your system right now, all right? So yes, that was a gentle reminder. That's a message I've been constantly getting since last 2 days. So I decided to record this audio. Cleanse yourself. And yes, probably from the coming week, I might start the shamanic readings. So give me your names on the personal chat. Let me know who all are interested in the shamanic readings. I will just make a note of all those names. Okay? Chalo then. On that note, this is Sunnchaali saying goodbye to all of you. Please do take good care of yourself. And yes, if you are feeling very gloomy and sleepy, honor your body. Sleep. You will not get this time again. Please sleep as much as you can. Your body needs that because your body is tired. All right? Chalo then. Take care. Bye-bye.